Okay, hi students. Today we will discuss about the next topic from this weekend portion. The theory is already we finished that Werner's theory. So this is the second one, that is valence bond theory. Okay, video one, that is valence bond theory. So valence bond theory. This is also called VBT. So valence bond theory is proposed by Linus Pauling. So his main concept, so in the formation of complex compounds, how the complex compounds formed and also their structures, he explained the formation of complex compounds or complexes, and also structures. He explained complexes, the formation of complex and their structures. He explained. So the postulates. According to this theory, the postulates, if you see, so number one, according to Linus Pauling in the valence bond theory, the central metal atom loses requisite number of electrons. Central metal atom loses requisite number of electrons, okay na, and forms requisite number of vacant orbitals so the number of electrons equal to how many electrons it loses, it is equal to oxidation number of central metal atom. So the number of electrons loses equal to oxidation number of central metal atom. The central metal atom particularly loses a particular number of electrons, okay na, and creates the vacant orbitals. Those formed vacant orbitals undergoes hybridization. So those vacant orbitals undergoes hybridization. So if hybridization, based on hybridization, he explained the structures, okay na, hybridization, type of hybridization, and also geometry or structure. For example, if the hybridization is sp2 mean what, in a trigonal planar, sp2 mean trigonal planar, and in complex compounds generally it is started from sp3, okay, sp3 tetrahedral, and dsp2, that is a square planar, and dsp3, okay na, dsp3, this is a square bipyramidal, sorry, that is trigonal bipyramidal. And next to D2SP3, octahedral geometry or structure, or SP3D2 also, that is also same octahedral. d2sp3 and sp3d2, that is octahedral dsp3 trigonal bipyramidal and dsp3 square planar sp3 tetrahedral. So in the next, in the valence bond theory, according to Linus Pauling, the central metal atom loses a requisite number of electrons and forms a requisite number of vacant orbitals. Those vacant orbitals undergo hybridization, and based on that, the molecule gives a particular geometry. Based on the hybridizations, the geometries, the structures. Okay, so next, then if our third point, if n minus 1 d orbital in hybridization, if in hybridization n minus 1 d orbital involved along with ns comma np orbitals, np orbitals of central metal atom, then that is called as number one, that is our inner orbital complex. Otherwise, spin paired complex. Number three, spin paired and low spin complex. Or it is also called as a strong field complex. And also it is called as a covalent complex. Okay, if in hybridization n minus 1 d orbital involved, n minus 1 mean from the last shell, second penultimate shell. Okay, now ultimate shell is the last shell, the penultimate shell is the from last it is a second shell, from last it is a second shell. So if penultimate shell is involved, that is n minus 1 d orbital is involved along with the ns and np orbitals, that complex is called as inner orbital complex, inner orbital and spin paired and low spin, strong field, otherwise covalent complex. These are the names when n minus 1 d orbital is involved. Whereas if nd orbital, mean outer orbital, d orbital is outer orbital. If in hybridization nd orbital, if in hybridization nd orbital involved along with ns comma np orbitals then of central metal atom, that is outer orbital complex. Otherwise, that complex also called as spin free complex. Otherwise, other name, high spin complex. And also it is also called weak field complex. And also it is called as ionic complex. Okay, along with ns mean last shell, n is the last outermost shell orbital. If outermost shell s orbital, outermost shell p orbital, outermost shell d orbital also involved in hybridization of the central metal atom, then the complex is said to be outer orbital complex or spin free complex or high spin complex or weak field and ionic complex. Ionic complex. Whereas n minus 1d, that means along with outermost s, outermost p orbital, the penultimate shell n minus 1d orbital is involved, that is called as inner orbital, spin field, low spin and strong field and covalent complexes. Okay, next how to take screenshots. Okay, next the central metal vacant orbital, these are the metal vacant orbitals. Okay, so the all ligands can be donate electron pairs to the central metal atom. Okay, now the ligands can be donate electron pairs to the central metal atom, the metal atom vacant orbitals. Okay, now and these ligands can be donate, L mean ligands, all ligands with electron pairs donate electron pairs to the central metal atom, forms covalent bonds. D-tube bonds are formed between the metal and ligand. Okay, now so the number of bonds formed equal to coordination number. And next, if you see